Hello, hello everybody! This is Milky! Welcome back to another Store of the Season Friends of the Mineral Town Let's Play! We're progressing in-game so fast and I'm looking forward for the Seasonal Pass content! Just in case you guys are curious, I did bought all the Seasonal Pass and for March, we should be able to have some cute special custom unlocked and the new cutscenes! So I can't wait when they will release the Seasonal Pass for March and share all the Seasonal Pass content with you! And let's start our today's video! A cutscene with Norman! Now that's rare, I think that's my first cutscene with him. And I want to know more about him. And he says, "Hi Milky, welcome!" Oh sorry, I bite my tongue accidentally. Well, I'm having a bad time and it seems like I couldn't do anything successfully. Please listen to me. Sure, we have a daughter, she's already matured and she went outside and started working. But I almost never talk to her much. Sometimes my wife will come here and live together. She talked to my daughter a lot, but I just don't know what to talk to her about. I heard that all the fathers in the world are like this. It seems to be meaningless if I'm troubled by this problem. Aw, poor Norman, he said, but sometimes I still feel lonely. Oh, what should I do? Oh, and we can give him some suggestions. Listen to the same music as her. Okay, that's not bad. Dance. Use dancing to attract her attention. Or use art to capture his heart or her heart. they're all kind of hilarious. I kind of want to say dancing just because it's funny. But okay, let's do it. Use dance to attract her attention. Dancing? Something that's popular right now? No. When I was young, I was laughed so much. Now I have a swoon against it. Oh, poor Norman. Plus, there's no point of being trying to be handsome and cool at my age. But even if I will be laughed at, I should give it a try. Ah, good. After talking to you, I feel so much better. Oh, that's good, Norman. Next time, if you have any trouble, it's my turn to help you. I'll get going late now. Thank you so much. Well, no problem, but it's your shop, Norman. You can't get going. I need to buy stuff from you. It's cool though. I love all the side cutscenes to help me know all the town people better. I guess I don't come to flower shop often, so I didn't get to trigger too much with her, so that's nice. She seems like she's reading a letter, and it says to Dear Ling, ever since Ling went to the village, it has been a while. How's your body? We have been the same. I guess it's not village, the town. Oh, I wonder who's Michela. Because of that, after you left, we were going to have a tea party like we used to, but I'm the only person left. Aww. Even though it's a little bit sad, but I'm going to continue have tea party even if just by myself. If you ever come back, please contact me. Your dear friend Sandra. Oh, that must be Ling's old friend. I wonder if she used to live in the city or somewhere. She must miss her friend. And Ling said, welcome, are you trying to find any flower? Ah, this. Well, it's a letter that's written from my old friend from the city. Even though I came here long time ago, she still sometimes writes letter like this to me. If you don't mind, I can pick a flower for you, what kind of flower you like. And we can pick bright flower, calm flower, or like really fancy flower. I kinda like the bright and the positive flower. Ah, okay, please wait. Is she ever actually going to get us a flower? That would be amazing. Is it like this? Even though this is the flower I made and it's not as beautiful as Grandpa. I remember, Milky, you work at the farm, right? What kind of the flower does the farm has? Well, I have all the flower that you wished. We actually haven't grown flower for a while. Sorry, suddenly ask you a weird question. Because I really like pick wild flowers and make pressed flower out of them. Aw, that's a cute hobby. It's like taking the season and the nature and transform them into diary. Aw, that's beautiful, Ling. And sometimes I also send my pressed flower to my friends in the city. Sorry, I've been talking all about myself. Well, no problem. Tell me more about you. Well, I'll see you next time. Please thank you for having a fun time with me. Well, no problem, Ling. She's such a good girl. I actually really like Ling's personality. She's so positive and cute. Hi, Yori! I feel like I haven't talked to Yori much and I really want to get better relationship with him. He does like rice ball. And thanks for the tips in the comment. Apparently, after we get good relationship with Yori and marry him, we will be able to unlock a secret character. So I'm going to take priority and give him rice balls and all the stuff he likes every single day. Oh, I didn't notice, but after our cousin with Ling, she will actually give us a bundle of flower which she made. That's so beautiful. I love it. We can put it at our home. I will definitely put it down. It's so beautiful. One thing that I noticed I almost never do is make the perfume or make the flower bundle. So I decided today, let's try to make some perfume because that's one of the things that Laura loves. And in order to make the perfume, we actually need essence. So I used the essence machine and put some flour in to get the essence and ta-da! We got the perfume. I decided to make two and then maybe ship one of the perfume just to see what happens. And there's all kinds of different perfumes. Also, we can make fruit flavored perfume. That one sounds pretty fun. Apparently, we need to put fruit into it. And it's not cheap to make perfume. I wonder, can we make money by turn flour into perfume? It's gonna be interesting. Oh, we can also make all different kind of flower bundles. I should have do it. I think a lot of people like them. Wow, I guess it's definitely not worth it if you're trying to make money out of this. Because I spent $3,000 to make the perfume, or 3,000 gold to make the perfume, but it actually could only sell for 200 gold. So, I guess it's a good gift, but not great moneymaker. Ta-da! I finally collected all the materials and ready to upgrade our golden axe. Upgrade to gold, it's definitely super expensive, and the next one is even more. It costs 150,000. That is so much. Well, I think we can do it if we keep trying, but the next thing I want to upgrade to gold, probably I don't have to, maybe the fishing rod, but other than that, I don't think we need gold items too much. Oh, it seems like I triggered a cutscene after I give the gifts to Clemens. Oh, I really want to know more about him. And he says, how worrisome. Oh, what happens, Clemens? Hello? Are you the guest? Sorry, I can't take any more drop today. I accidentally hurt myself when I was using the fire. Oh, sorry to hear that. Are you okay? I thought it's just a small injury, but I won't be able to do work that requires precision. So until my wound is recovered, I don't think I can work anymore. Oh right, do you know who can help me cure this injury? And we have a few options we can suggest. Either the Grandpa Nguyen, or we can suggest Misaki or Doseku. It's kinda hard to tell. Maybe Doseku? I don't know who will be good at it. I just noticed we don't have a doctor in town. We need them. Dosetsu? Well, I guess we do have common interest, but I didn't heard that he knows how to cure injury. I guess we need to guess again. Maybe Grandpa Nguyen? Grandpa Nguyen? Oh, right, he really knows plants. Maybe he knows some plants that could cure my injury. Oh, good. At least we guess one thing right. Ah, okay, injury. Okay, just wait here for a while. Grandpa Nguyen is so nice. He knows how to grow flowers. He also knows how to cure injury. Here, this I can give it to you. It's aloe. And all you need to do is just put that on your wound. Aloe? Okay. Yeah, like this. You can peel through the hard places and take this. Wow, Grandpa Nguyen, you're so nice. This is awesome. Thank you. You really did me a good favor. Ah, no worries. You don't need to say thank you. You're welcome back anytime. Wow, today, all the town people in town are just so nice. And I love how they help each other. I wish we can get a doctor later in game. That would be cool. And Clement says, thank you, Milky. It's all thanks to you and your awesome suggestion. Well, no problem. Now I should get back to work and I can finally catch up on all the work I missed. Well, thanks for all your hard work. Hopefully I can get my motorcycle back soon. Just want to demonstrate how powerful our gold axe is. Ta-da! You can see we can cover a big base of the forest with our gold axe, and we can get a lot of tree chopping done by upgrading it. I would definitely recommend to upgrade axe and hammer as soon as possible. It just makes your farming life so much easier, and you can get a lot more done. Oh, good morning and hello, Clemens! I think this is the second time he ever visited us in the morning, and he says, sorry to disturb you like this, but could you come to our shop? Is my motorcycle ready? I'm so looking forward to it! I hope so! I finished all the quests, so I could only hope. Ta-da! That's my pink motorcycle! And he says, the motorcycle that you put here has already been fixed. Thank you, Clemens! Oh, you're the best! I'm so happy! Look, doesn't it already look like you used to be? And I think you should be able to ride it now. Sorry for spending so much time. I make this motorcycle much less likely to be broken. That's good to know. I don't want my motorcycle to be broken again. As for the money to pay my fixing fee, how about that? How about we go and have a motorcycle ride together next time? You're so nice, Lars. He fixed our motorcycle and all he wants is having a trip. And he said, I was very looking forward to have a motorcycle ride with you. Aww, that is so sweet. I can't believe Lars is not a marriage candidate. He's such a great guy. And he said, if you want to change the motorcycle color, just let my brother know. I will paint whatever color you like. Thank you. I will send the motorcycle to you to your home later today. Let me know if there's any conditions and you can come to the shop and find me. You guys are the best. I will definitely... Oh, I can't wait to ride my motorcycle. I wonder how fast is it? Is it faster than our little horse? And we got achievement for getting our motorcycle back. And apparently today is Laura's birthday, so we also should remember to give her a birthday gift. And here's my cute little motorcycle! Look at it! It's amazing and super fun to ride! I love it! I love it so much! I don't think I can travel any way other than riding the motorcycle now. Maybe I can travel by horse once in a while. And I was thinking that I forgot to put the flower that Lin gave us at home. Ta-da! It looks beautiful! I love it! I'm running out of spaces to put all the stuff I earned. For example, this gold cup for winning the pet festival. Apparently, it could be sold and for a decent amount of money. But I think I want to keep it for our old memory's sake. I think Annie will be sad if I just sell the cup that we earned together. We can actually fish from the puddle. I have no idea. And apparently, it will give us a special fish. I think it's lobster, and it will be required for us to finish some of the early cooking requests. I've been trying to find where to fish lobster everywhere, and apparently it needs to be from the puddle. Ta-da! Oh, maybe not. It's not a lobster. It looks like it, but I think it's some kind of a special small shrimp that we can get from the puddle. But anyways, we finally got it. I'm happy. Lucky, here's a cutscene with Bess. And she said, it seems like I forgot something, but what is it? It seems like I said I'm going to have a date with somebody. Maybe I forgot to get my clothes from outside? No, I got all my clothes, that I remember. Did I forgot to eat? She's hilarious. Well, for the food, I think I just eat. Speaking of that, the food was really, really good. Maybe the date? Date? Oh, she's having a date! Ah, I was supposed to have a date with Lars! I didn't know Bess and Lars was having a date! This is almost like a rival cousin, but I guess that makes sense. That's why they're not marriage candidate, because they're boyfriend and girlfriend? And Bess says, oh, what should I do? I forgot all about it. Oh, Bess. I'm here to pick you up, Bess! Oh, hi, Lars! Lars! Oh, you must be working hard and forgot our date again. Yeah, what should I say? I'm going to go prepare. Could you wait for a little bit? Yeah, sure. I was a little bit sad about Lars and Bess are not marriage candidate, but it's cool to see their date. And Bess says, sorry for making you wait for a long time. Hey, it's faster than I imagined. Sorry, you always had to wait for me. Oh, no worries. Well, ever since you came here, I finally realized how happy I am. Let's go. Oh, Lars is so nice. And Bess says, let's go. Aww, that's good for them. Today is one of our marriage candidates' birthday. So, hi, Laura. Aww, I'm so impressed. It's rainy and her birthday, but she's still working. Oh, that's good for you, Laura. And here's your perfume. I hope you like it. Is this my birthday gift? I'm so happy. Yep, yep, it is. Let's see how's our heart with Laura going. Where's Laura? Oh, she's pretty down there. I guess I haven't talked to her much. There we go. At least we got one heart. I went outside and here's a little sheep waiting outside in the street and it says meh. I have no idea whose cussing it is, but it sure is cute. Maybe it's another one with Damon? That would be funny. Oh, and Bridget is here and she said, ah, you're here, Francis. It's funny how all her animals sound so fancy and have a fancy name. Hello, Bridget. Oh, yeah. Sorry, I paid all my attention into Francis. That's her name. She just got lost and I've been trying to find her. Aww, your animal. Their animal shop's animal get lost all the time. The cows, the sheep, it's just funny. And we can ask, can we pet them? Can we feed them? Or can we smell his smell? That is so weird. I kind of want to try the last one, just for funsies. I don't think Bridget will be happy about it. Oh, she actually seems super happy. And she says, you understand too? That smell of rain and sunset. Oh my god. I didn't realize she actually enjoyed it. And she said, I feel like we could be good friends. Oh, good, good, good. I think we can be good friends too. And she said, ah, is that my mistake? What happened? Sorry. Nothing happens. It's just, I feel like I seen something. What did you see? I feel like I see fairy. Oh, maybe she can see fairy too? That would be awesome. I remember I saw them a few times when I was young, but I wasn't able to see them anymore when I grew up. But I believe that fairy exists, even though I can't see them, but they're always here. Me. It seems like her sheep agreed. What? You're hungry? Fine, let's go back home then. I'll see you later. Well, see you later, Bridget. That was really cool. And yes, you're right. Fairy does exist. I noticed my cooking skill isn't great, so I'm trying to level up. And one thing is we can finish the quest from Lovett's home. And one of the things we need is actually sugar. In order to get sugar, we need to get this spice processor. And all we need is just some wood and some iron bar. Honestly, I should do it a long time ago. And the reason we want this spice processor is then we can put plants in and get sugar out of it. We do need sugar for one of the desserts that we're making, so I'm going to get one sugar out. And then let's put it somewhere. Oh wow, we have so many processors, so it's hard to find a place for it. I think this is a good place. There we go, I cleaned the area up and then put it right here. Ta-da! Now we can put this in and get sugar. Sugar is needed for a lot of desserts, so definitely recommend it. Today, when I walked to the general store, I triggered another cutscene. Hopefully it's another Jake's heart cutscene. That will be his fourth one. And here's Angela says, welcome, if you're trying to find Jake. Oh, if you're trying to find Jack. Oops, Jax. Oh, I really need to remember his name if he's gonna be the first person we married. I'll be so ashamed if during marriage time I said his name wrong. And Jack says, Milky, you're here to find me? Since you spent all the trouble finding me here, I can give you these gifts. What is it, Jack? That's awesome. It's a little yo-yo ball for welcome you to the olive town. I want to make this one of the famous souvenirs for our town, so I made it a lot. Jack, you have some all kinds of weird ideas. But Cindy says nobody wants things like that. I think I would want it. That's funny. So I yelled it at her, but now that I think about it, I feel I'm wrong, so I want to go and apologize to her when we're back. That's good, Jack. I guess he does fight with Cindy a lot, but they do love each other. And Angela says, you're back, Cindy is inside. You're mature now, you should go and say sorry to her. Cindy, I'm so sorry. I shouldn't yell at you. Please be angry, Cindy. I'll buy anything for you. And here's Cindy. She doesn't look that sad. Hey, sorry, I shouldn't yell at you. then give me a glass snowball. Glass snowball? All you want is something like that? Aw, Cindy is such a good girl. There you go. I heard Jack has a lot. I have it. And Cindy says, more. More? How many snowball is on Jack's body? That's so funny that he just carries snowball around. And suddenly Cindy ran. So Angela says, wait, where are you going? Are you going to go find Mikey? I'm going to the sea. To the sea? Oh, she's gonna throw the snowball. It's all linked to the previous cutscene with Cindy. That's gonna be so funny. Of course she's gonna throw it into the sea. And she says, brother, you're so silly. That's a hilarious way to release her anger. And Jake says, fine, as long as you can forgive me. But just a note, I don't think we should throw garbage or snowball into the sea. And she threw another one and she said, bugger or silly. both of them? And then she threw another one. And Jack said, oh. And Cindy said, you have another one, right? Give it to me. Even that one? And we can either suggest Jack to give it to her or not. I'm not sure whether our choices in Olive Town make any differences about relationship. So I'm just gonna choose the one that I feel kind of funny. Just give it to her, Jack. Let her throw it all. What? You said give it to her? Oh, I hope he's not angry at us. But I think Cindy need to unleash her anger, so why not? I did got a yo-yo board from Jack in the end. And we can put it into our shelf too. All this funny souvenir he's given to me. It's so cute. I love it. Wow, as I start getting better relationship with everybody, we just have cussing after cussing. I do love how much cussing we can get in the first year. And here's Grandpa Nguyen, and he says, is that Yori? Right. We said that we're going to go fishing together. Oh, sorry. Seems like I was wrong. I'm surprised. Actually, Yori might be a good friend of Grandpa Nguyen. And he says, okay, then I guess I'll get some rest. Right. Do you like fishing? Well, I do like fishing. I think I should fish more in the game. Oh, wow. Okay, since you like fishing, can you talk about something with me? I and Yori are friends of fishing, and it's supposed to be I'm the master and he's the apprentices. But lately, Yori always get the big fish, so I don't think I can be the master anymore. Oh, he looks so sad. Oh, even though I'm at this age, but it still feels sad when I lose to somebody else. Well, I can totally understand. What should we do if we wanna get big fish? Oh, and we have some options. You need to focus on it. You need to put all your motivation on the fish rod. Make yourself the fish bait. That is hilarious. I really, really, really tempted to pick that one. You know what? Let's pick it. Please don't make yourself your bait though, Grandpa Nguyen. I love that option. And he says, oh, I see. Make myself the bait and then you use the fish rod? No. That's a horrible idea. But anyways, I should thank you. I think I should win today. I'm glad that he realized it's a horrible idea. It's kind of funny though. And he's like, wow. Before Yori come, I should go get another nap. Thank you, willing to speak to me. No problem. It was a funny chat, Grandpa Nguyen. Who knew that it would be so interesting? And another thing I came here today is to make a bouquet. So today is Katrina's birthday, and this is one of her favorite items. Well, this is her absolutely loved item, which is an earth bouquet. I did got all the flower required, so let's just make it. You can see we can make tons of bouquet, all kinds of ones, and there's a lot of people liking them. So I would recommend if you get some flowers early in the game, don't sell them, and just save some flowers so you can make bouquet later. They're great gifts. So let me collect all the flowers. Oh, there we go. All the flower ready. And it's just 400 gold. Ta-da! We got it! Oh wow, it has been crazy. It seems like no matter where I go, I get tongue people and cousins. And here's Katrina, and she says, Oh, you're right on time. I have something I want to ask you to help. Oh, you don't need to be too worried. I just want you to answer some questions. So I'm going to get started. What do you think this tongue is? It's a really relaxed farming tongue. It's just a normal tongue that we can see anywhere.Well, I think it's a really relaxing village tongue, and that's the type of tongue that I really like. And Katrina says it right. This tongue is really relaxed, it has nothing. It's almost like a brand new canvas. Aww, and next question, if you can use a music to describe this tongue, what kind of music do you think? A really positive and upbeat one, some lazy one, or it's a lullaby? I think maybe it's a lullaby. It's just kind of funny. Lullaby? Okay. Now the last question. What kind of animal can represent this tongue? An eagle that flies freely in the sky, a dolphin that travels in the sea, or a fly? A fruit fly? Oh, that's hilarious. I almost want to select that, but I don't think so. I think it's a dolphin that travels in the sea. Right. Yeah, traveling across the sea, the never-ending sea. Even though there's some places I don't agree, but overall, I think you did great. Your weird taste gave me a lot of inspiration. Thank you so much. I'll use your opinion to make my design from now on. Well, I'm glad I didn't choose fruit fly. I don't want any of the clothes she designed have some fruit flies on it. It would be hilarious though. And she says, one day, maybe I'll ask you to help again. But it's nice to talk to you. Well, it's nice to talk to you too, Katrina. Oh. Hello. And I think I should give her the gifts. Oh, whoops. I almost missed it. There you go. Here you go, Katrina, have your birthday gift. Happy birthday. Thank you. Is it my birthday gift? I'll take it. I'm not sure. It almost feels like she doesn't care and she's not happy. But we did got almost 2 hearts out of it. Well, I think maybe we were already at 1 heart. But anyways, I think that was a pretty good gift and I'm glad she's happy. After a long time, I can finally deliver this quest from Lovett. So, I think we can get some good stuff out of it. Ta-da! Let's take a look. It seems like we got some cocoa powder, some flour, and some coffee powder. That's awesome! I think with the coffee powder, once we unlock coffee, we will be able to make black coffee for Damon and get a lot of heart from him. I still really love Lovett's place. It's funny how it's so grand from outside and then a broken bed right here. And I think that wraps up our today's video. I'm super looking forward to the summer festival in the next episode. And I'm so happy that we were able to trigger so many cutscenes. I think we might be getting close to the marriage events. I'm looking forward to it. So far, I'm getting really good relationship with Diamond and Jack, so I'm wondering which one I'm going to marry first. Thank you guys so much for watching and still supporting this series, and special thanks for my awesome Patreon donors. You guys are the absolute best, and I'll see you guys next time!